and welcome to episode 16 of our Motor Glider restoration. If you didn't see the previous episodes, then check out the playlist in the top right corner. This time we will replace all the fuel lines below the fuel tank and completely restore the luggage shelf behind the seats. The fuel lines that we got with the plane were very dried out and inflexible. We therefore decided to replace all of them. Everything of course with the proper documentation. The fuel lines have a lifetime limit, which probably has been exceeded by now, and this way we don't have to determine how old they actually were. We start by disassembling the old hoses from their fittings and connectors. In contrast to the hoses themselves, these can be reused. Here you can see how stiff the old hoses became. We then just used the originals to make new ones of the same length and reassembled everything. Some hose clamps keep the fuel lines in place on the connectors. The fuel indicator on this plane is really advanced. It's just a transparent tube that shows the fuel level in the tank. You just look at the level in the tube and read the liters of fuel remaining on the plate next to it. However, over time this tube became very discolored and brittle. If it were to fail, it would dump the contents of the fuel tank in the fuselage, so it's important to replace it in time. A spring inside the tube limits the radius and prevents it from getting pinched. It was a little tricky to get out, but we managed. By laying out all the pieces of the old tube, we determined the length of the new one. I made a simple hook to pull the spring into the new transparent tube. With the spring in place, the hook could easily be removed by twisting it a few times. With everything assembled, we could mount it to the tank in the fuselage and the metal fuel lines that are permanently attached to the plane. This is quite a fiddly job. If I would have to do it again, I would assemble the fuel lines before mounting the fuel tank. But we managed to get them all in place and properly secured. Behind the seats is a shelf that can be used for documents and a little bit of luggage. I'm quite sure the shelf still had the original fabric, which is 50 years old now. As we are restoring the whole plane, we couldn't leave it like this, of course. We therefore removed all the old covering. Here we can see just how crumbly the foam in between the layers got. After removing all the fabric, we sanded away the remaining glue and foam and started to apply the new covering. When we ordered the new fuel lines, we also got the new fabric, which funnily enough also came with a Form 1. After marking and cutting out the smaller pieces first, it was time to try gluing them into place. We both never really done any fabric covering like this, so it was a little bit of a learning process. We found out that only gluing the edges gives a much nicer result than gluing the whole surface. And yes, we had to redo them once. but in the end the result is good, I think. With some practice done, it was time to go for the large piece. We applied the same method here, just glued the edges to keep it in place, then fold it around to the back. This was all done with contact glue, so you apply it on both sides, let it dry and then press it together for instant adhesion. For a couple of beginners in fabric covering, I think we got quite a nice result. For sure it's an improvement over the old fabric. We then cut the slot for the fuel indicator, made holes for the screws, tapped the holes to remove paint, and mounted the two small pieces of the shelf in place. When we restored the large section, we found the screw missing in one of the hinges and replaced it. But when trying to mount it, we figured out that screw was missing for a reason. Therefore, we removed most of it to make it fit. With that done, we could mount the large section of the shelf as well. Later, we will mount the fuel indicator tube properly. But this will be something for the next episode. Thanks for watching, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please leave a like and consider subscribing. See you next time!